Samuel chapter 30.
Samueli wa kwanza 30.
I'll read verse 8.
Nitasoma mstari ni wa 8.
The Bible says, so David inquired of the Lord, saying, shall I pursue this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for you shall surely overtake them, and without fail recover all.
Daudi akauliza kwa Bwana akasema, je, nikiwafuata jeshi hili, nitawapata? Naye akamjibu, fuata, kwa kuwa hakika utawapata, nawe hukosi, utawapokonya wote.
Joel 2:25.
Yoeli 2:25.
Joel chapter 2 and verse 25.
Yoeli 2:25.
The Bible says, and I will restore. Joel 2:25. So I will restore to you the years that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust, my great army which I sent among you.
Nami nitawarudishia hiyo miaka iliyoliwa na nzige, na parare, na madumadu, na tunutu, jeshi langu kubwa nililotuma kati yenu.
I wanted to turn to somebody and tell them God will restore.
Nataka umwageukie mtu ukamwambie Mungu atarejesha.
Tell the other neighbor you will recover.
Ambia huyo mwingine ya kuwa utaweza kupata sehemu yako.
God will restore.
Bwana atarejesha.
And you will recover.
Na utaweza kupata yote.
You will not just recover, you like David will recover all.
Hautapata tu, lakini wewe kama Daudi utapata yote.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Lift up your right hand and say, I will recover.
Inua mkono wako wa kuume na useme nitapata.
Say, God will restore.
Sema Bwana atarejesha.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to talk to us briefly.
Nataka kunena nasi kwa ufupi.
On the God of restoration.
Kuhusu Mungu wa urejesho.
Or God will restore.
Au Mungu atarejesha.
However, the message will come out. But I want you to know as we start that God is a restorer. God is a God that brings recovery. What is restoration?
Kuweza kupata ni nini?
What is recovery?
Na kuweza kurejeshewa ni nini?
Recovery or restoration, number one, is the recovery of that which was lost.
Nambari ya kwanza ni kupata kile kilichokuwa kimepotea.
Restoration is the recovery of what was lost.
Ni kupata kile kilichopotea.
In 2 Kings chapter 6 and verse 1.
Wafalme wa pili 6 mstari ni wa kwanza.
The Bible talks about the sons of the prophet.
Maandiko yanazungumza kuhusu wale wana wa manabii.
They went to Elisha and said, see now, the place where we dwell with you is too small for us.
Wakamwendea wakamwambia mahali ambapo umetupa ni padogo sana.
Verse 2.
Mstari wa pili.
Please let us go to the Jordan and let every man take a beam from there. Let us make there a place where we may dwell. So he answered, go.
Basi twende mpaka Yordani, twakuomba tutwae huko kila mtu mti mmoja ili tujifanyie huko mahali pa kukaa. Akajibu, haya nendeni.
Then one said, please consent to go with your servants. And he answered, I will go.
Mmoja wao akasema, uwe radhi, basi nakusihi, uende pamoja na watumishi wako. Akajibu, nitakwenda.
Verse 4, so he went with them, and when they came to the Jordan, they cut down trees.
Mstari wa 4, basi akaenda pamoja nao, na walipofika Yordani, wakakata miti.
Verse 5. But as one was cutting down a tree, the iron axe head fell into the water, and he cried out and said, alas, master, for it was borrowed.
Lakini moja wapo, alipokuwa katika kukata boriti, chuma cha shoka kikaanguka majini. Akalia akasema, ole wangu, bwana wangu, kwani kiliazimiwa kile.
So the man of God said, where did it fall?
Mtu wa Mungu akasema kilianguka wapi?
And he showed him the place.
Akamuonyesha mahali.
So he cut off a stick and threw it in there and he made the iron float.
Akakata kijiti, akakitupa pale pale, chuma kikaelea.
So there was a recovery.
Kwa hivyo kulikuwa na kupata
kilichopotea. He said, pick it up for yourself.
Anasema ichukue wewe mwenyewe.
So he reached out his hand and took it.
Akasema kiokote basi akaonyesha akaunyosha mkono akakitoa.
There will be a restoration on this mountain.
Utakuwa na kurejeshewa katika mlima huu.
What is restoration?
Kurejeshewa ni nini?
Number 2.
Mara ya pili.
It is the realization of that which is lacking.
Ni ile kutambua kile kinachokosa.
The realization of what is lacking.
Kutambua kile kinachokosa.
In 2 Kings chapter 4.
Wafalme wa pili 4.
Verse 13.
Mstari ni wa 13.
To verse 17.
Hadi 17.
And he said to him, say now to her, look, you have been concerned for us with all this care. What can I do for you? Do you want me to speak on your behalf to the king or to the commander of the army? She answered, I dwell among my own people. Let me just read through. Verse 14. So he said, what then is to be done for her? And Gehazi answered, actually, she has no son, and her husband is old. So he said, call her. When he had called her, she stood in the doorway. Then he said, about this time next year, he shall embrace her son. And she said, no, my Lord, man of God, do not lie to your maid servant. But the woman conceived and bore a son when the appointed time had come, of which Elisha had told her. This woman didn't have a son.
Binti huyu hakuwa na mwana.
And she had learned to live with the lack.
Na alikuwa amezoea kuishi vivyo hivyo.
So her life was going on without a child.
Kwa hivyo maisha yake alikuwa anaendelea bila mwana.
She didn't know she needed a child.
Hakujua kuwa anahitaji mwana.
Until when the man of God stepped in the picture.
Hadi wakati mtumishi wa Mungu alipotokea.
Is when she realized.
Ndipo akagundua.
There was something she was lacking in her life.
Kuna kitu alikuwa nakosa katika maisha yake.
I believe, God, that you are coming here.
Naamini ya kwamba kuja kwako hapa.
God will use it to open your eyes.
Mungu atatumia kufungua macho yako.
To see what you are lacking in your life.
Ukaweza kuona kile kinachokosa katika maisha yako.
And you won't just see it.
Na hautaona tu.
God will give it to you.
Mungu atakupatia.
I thought I heard you say amen.
Nadhani nilisikia ukisema amina.
What is restoration?
Kurejeshewa ni nini?
Restoration number 3. Is the renewal or revival of what is diminishing. The revival of what is diminishing. Somebody was on fire.
Mtu alikuwa kwenye moto,
but they are no longer on fire.
Lakini hawapo tena pale.
They need a restoration.
Wanahitaji urejesho.
The church was growing.
Kanisa ilikuwa inakuwa.
But it is no longer growing the way it was.
Haikui tena jinsi ilivyokuwa inakuwa.
Instead, it is reducing.
Lakini inapunguka.
You need a restoration.
Unahitaji urejesho.
Maybe you had a business.
Yaweza kuwa ulikuwa na biashara.
And people are flocking in that business.
Na watu walikuwa wanamiminika mahali pale.
But after some time,
lakini baada ya muda,
they are no longer flocking your way.
Hawa watu hawaji tena kwako.
There is need for renewal.
Unahitaji wa kuweza
kurejeshwa. There is need for revival.
Unahitaji ya uvivio.
Because what is happening is that you are losing out. What is restoration number 4? Restoration is the return to the original state. Return to the original state. Or condition of a thing. In 2 Kings chapter 5. The Bible talks about a man in verse 1.
Maandiko yanasema kuhusu huyu jamaa mstari wa kwanza.
He says, now Naaman, commander of the army of the king of Syria, was a great and honorable man in the eyes of his master, because by him the Lord had given victory to Syria. He was also a mighty man of valor, but a leper. So Naaman was born with a good skin. But he was attacked with leprosy. And eventually, he rose up to become a mighty man, yet with leprosy. In verse 14, the Bible says, after receiving instruction, he went down and dipped 7 times in the Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God. And his flesh was restored like the flesh of a little child. And he was clean. I prophesy the return to your original condition. The very place where you used to be. The very place where you enjoy. I believe that on this mountain, there will be a restoration. I want to talk briefly about the categories of people that need restoration. Categories of men and women that need restoration. Possibly you are among those people. Number one category of those that need restoration are those who are struggling. The people who are struggling. Number two category of the people who need restoration are those who are going from bad to worse. Their condition is growing from bad to worse. In Mark chapter 5 and verse 25, the Bible talks about a woman that had an issue of blood for 12 years. Verse 26. And had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had and was not better, but rather grew worse. There are people who, rather than growing better, they are growing worse. Instead of their relationship growing better, it's growing worse. You need restoration. The third category of men and women that need restoration are those that sow in tears, but they remain in tears. They are wonderful sowers, but their condition is not changing. The Bible says in Psalm 126, he that goes out weeping, carrying seed to sow, shall without doubt return,
bila shaka atarudi,
bringing sheaves with him. Verse 5 says, those that sow in tears shall reap in joy. But there are people who sow in tears and they remain in tears. It's like they are losing what they are sowing. They pray in tears and remain in tears. They serve in tears but remain in tears. On this mountain, there will be a restoration. You will not sow in tears and remain in tears. I pray for you in the name of Jesus that on this mountain you will have a harvest. Your harvest will begin on this mountain. I want you to know you didn't waste your time. You did well to come because you needed restoration. Number four category of people that need restoration are those whose labor is more than their favor. Their labor is more than their favor. They labor more, but there is no trace of favor upon them. And because of that, struggle is the order of the day. You need restoration. Number five category of men and women that need restoration are those that the devil keeps on handing to them dead stuff. The devil always hands to them what is dead. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are you people with me? Lastly,
Mwishoe,
number of people that need restoration
watu ambao wanahitaji urejesho
are those who are plagued by losses
ni wale ambao wamejawa na kupoteza
and setbacks.
Na ile hali ya kutopata.
Plagued by losses
wanapata kupoteza
and setbacks
na kuharibikiwa.
That means they have been losing.
Hiyo inamaanisha wamekuwa tu wakipoteza.
They have been losing.
Wamekuwa tu wakipoteza.
You are here.
Uko hapa.
And you are among these six category of men.
Uko kati au miongoni mwa hawa sita.
Either in one of more of them.
Kati ya moja au nyingi zaidi.
I want you to know.
Ningependa ujue.
God is a restorer.
Mungu ni wa urejesho.
God will restore.
Mungu atakurejeshea.
Let me hear you say amen.
Wacha nisikie ukisema amina.
Let me deal with number 6.
Wacha niangalie nambari ya 6.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Restoration.
Urejesho.
Is possible.
Inawezekana.
Despite setbacks and losses.
Kando na ile hali ya kushambuliwa na kupoteza.
You've had setbacks.
Uko na kushambuliwa.
You have had losses.
Umepoteza.
And you are saying, Pastor,
na unasema mchungaji,
I don't think I will ever recover.
Sidhani kama nitawahi weza kupata.
Some of you are hit by corona.
Wengine mligongwa na corona.
Since the time of corona.
Tangia wakati wa corona.
The loss you experienced.
Hasara uliyopata.
You have not recovered.
Haujaweza kupata urejesho.
The setback you experienced. You have not recovered. I came to tell you, you did well to come to Mountain Takers because restoration is possible despite your setbacks and your losses. Setbacks are real. Losses are real. In the book of Ruth, chapter 1, there is a man called Elimelech that went to the land of Moab. And when he got there, the Bible said he had two sons. They got married to Moabite women. After 10 years, the man died. So Naomi, the wife, lost her husband. After some time, the two sons died. So Naomi lost the husband and lost the sons. Her two daughters lost their husbands. That was a loss. That was a setback. They needed a restoration. And when you go through the book of Ruth, you will discover there was a restoration. I prophesy a restoration for a Ruth here. There is a Ruth here. You will have a restoration from this mountain. Number two person that had losses. Second Kings chapter 4 and verse 1. The Bible talks about a certain woman of the wives of the sons of the prophets. She said, your servant, my husband, is dead.
Akasema mtumishi wako mume wangu amekufa.
Although he feared the Lord.
Ngawaje alimcha Mungu.
And the creditor is coming to take my two sons.
Na mdeni wangu anakuja kuchukua vijana wangu wawili.
So the woman lost her husband.
Kwa hivyo huyu mama alipoteza mume.
Who was in debts.
Ambaye alikuwa kwa madeni.
And they transferred the debts to her.
Na akaweza kuweka hayo madeni kwake.
She had made losses.
Alikuwa amefanya hasara.
She had a setback.
Alikuwa na kushambuliwa.
And they were threatening to take the sons as collateral.
Na walikuwa wanamtishia kuchukua wanawake kulipa madeni.
But if you go through this story.
Ukisoma hadithi hii.
There was a restoration.
Ulikuwa na urejesho.
I prophesy a restoration.
Ninatabiri urejesho.
To somebody who is here and you are in debts.
Kwa mtu ambaye uko hapa na uko kwa madeni.
Pray in the name of Jesus. The God of restoration will visit you. The last example I have of losses and setbacks is that of Job. Job chapter 1 from verse 13. The Bible says, now there was a day.
Kulikuwa na siku.
There was a day.
Kulikuwa na siku.
There is a day when Satan attacks.
Kuna siku ambayo Shetani ushambulia.
But there is also a day when God visits to restore.
Na pia kuna siku ambayo Mungu kutembelea ili kukurejesha.
And I sense that this week is the day.
Na mimi nahisi kwamba
that God is visiting somebody to restore.
Ya kuwa Mungu anatembelea mtu kumrejeshea.
There was a day.
Kulikuwa na siku.
When his sons and daughters were eating and drinking wine. In their oldest brother's house, verse 14. And a messenger came to Job and said, the oxen were plowing and the donkeys were feeding beside them. Verse 15. When the Sabians raided them and took them away, indeed they have killed the servants with the edge of the sword, and I alone have escaped to tell you. And on and on one day,
Na kuendelea.
Job had setbacks.
Ayubu alikuwa ameshambuliwa.
Job lost.
Ayubu alipoteza.
But the story of Job does not end here.
Lakini hadithi ya Ayubu haishii hapa.
And your story will not end here.
Na hadithi yako pia haitaishia hapa.
Your story will not end in your challenges.
Hadithi yako haitaishia katika kushambuliwa.
Your story will end in your deliverance.
Hadithi yako itaishia kwa wewe kukemkolewa.
I am sharing with you so simply. But I want you to hear the voice of God. Your story will not end here. God will give you a visitation. If you are with me, shout hallelujah. I want you to know you can bounce back from setbacks. You can bounce back from setbacks. Lift up your hand and say, I can bounce back from setbacks. Proverbs 24 and verse 16. A righteous man will fall 7 times and arise again. I said he will arise again. You will bounce back in the name of Jesus. Micah chapter 7 and verse 8. The Bible says, rejoice not over me, O my enemies. Do not rejoice over me, my enemy. When I fall, I will arise. I don't know who fell here. I brought you good news. You will arise. I don't know who is down here. I brought you good news. You will arise. In such a gathering,
it's
not everybody who has money.
It's
not everybody who is doing well. There are some people who have been beaten. And they are on the floor. They are the people I was sent to talk to. I came to tell you, you will bounce back. I said you will bounce back. I brought you a simple message. It's a message of restoration. You will bounce back. And those who are rejoicing over you, they will realize eyes. The Lord is a light unto you. He says, do not rejoice over me, my enemy. When I fall, I will arise. When I sit in darkness, I will not remain in darkness. Maybe where you are not seeing your way out. You don't know how you will come out. I brought you the Lord who is the light. I said, I brought you the Lord who is the light. The Lord on this mountain is becoming a light unto you. Can I hear you shout amen? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let me share with you simply. Let me share with you simply some of the things God can restore. Of course, God can restore all things. But I will share with you some things that God will restore as you follow me on this mountain. God can restore back your joy. God can restore back your joy. Are you with me? God can restore back your joy. Joy is powerful. Joy is spiritual. Joy is powerful. Joy is necessary in the life of a child of God. Are you with me? Joy is so important that when David lost it, he prayed in Psalm 51 and verse 12. And he said, restore unto me the joy of my salvation. There is something that happens with people. When they get born again, they receive the joy of the Lord. They may not have money, but they have joy. They may not have a place to stay, but somehow they have a joy. And I was learning the other day that joy is a cushion. It is a shock absorber. Joy has a way of preventing you from slipping into depression. When joy is there, it doesn't matter how tough the situation is. You will discover you can go through. And I believe it was the joy of the Lord that enabled men like David to walk through the valley of the shadow of death. So you hear David say, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for God is with me. In the valley of the shadow of death, you expect a man to be depressed. You expect a man to be worried. But because of the joy of the Lord, David said, I'm walking through. I brought you the joy of the Lord. And I'm praying that you receive a restoration of the joy of the Lord. The devil has a way of using the things we go through to visit us with the spirit of mourning, the spirit of heaviness. But on this mountain, may God give you beauty for ashes. I'm saying, may God give you beauty for ashes. The oil of joy for mourning. And the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Nothing will help you walk to the place of your deliverance
kutembea mahali pako
pa like having the joy of the Lord on your inside.
Kama kukua na furaha ya Bwana ndani yako.
In the journey of our wilderness.
Katika hali ya kutembea kwetu.
We need the joy of the Lord.
Tunahitaji furaha ya Bwana.
I said in the journey through your wilderness.
Katika kupita katika
you need the joy of the Lord.
Tunahitaji furaha ya Bwana.
It will not always be easy.
Haitakuwa rahisi kila wakati.
In this kingdom. But the joy of the Lord, when it is on your inside, you will make it on this journey. You are here and your challenge is depression. I pray that as the word comes forth, the yoke of depression, what is making you want to hide because you are not as good as others, because you are not as successful as others, you were together but now they have gone ahead, and when you look at them you feel bad. That bad feeling is what I came to address. Receive a restoration of the joy of the Lord, because recovery is possible. I said recovery is possible. You need joy because number one, joy is medicinal. Proverbs 17 and verse 22. The Bible says, Proverbs 17, 20, a merry heart does good like medicine. You want to keep your life healthy? Connect to the joy of the Lord. I say connect to the joy of the Lord. As the yoke of depression breaks on your head, healing comes in your body. Shout hallelujah. You need joy because number two, joy is key to productivity and prosperity. You cannot deliver maximally in the place of depression. It doesn't matter what you are doing. If there is no joy, your results will not be what they are supposed to be. You need the joy of the Lord to be productive. You need the joy of the Lord to be able to prosper. Joel chapter 1 and verse 12. The Bible says, Joel 1 and verse 12, the vine has dried up and the fig tree has withered, the pomegranate tree, the palm tree also, and the apple tree, all the trees of the field are withered. Why? Because joy is withered away from the sons of men. The easiest way to become poor is to have 6 o'clock face and maintain it because of what you think is happening around you. Even what is not dried will dry. All the trees of the field are withered. Why? Because joy is withered from the sun, which means if joy was there, you will keep some things alive. I said you will keep some things alive to the point where God brings you full restoration. Receive the joy of the Lord. Joy is necessary, number three, because joy supplies the strength you need. Joy is the supplier of the strength that you need, number one, in the journey of life. You need strength in the journey of life. Nehemiah 8 and verse 10. You need strength in the journey of life. Nehemiah is encouraging this man. Then he said to them, go your way, eat the fat, drink the sweet, Send portions to those whom for whom nothing is prepared, for this day is holy to our Lord. Do not sorrow. Can you turn to somebody and tell them, do not sorrow? I don't know what you left at home, but do not sorrow about it. Do not sorrow. Tell somebody again, do not sorrow. Tell them, I can sense the sorrow in your heart. Do not sorrow. Because there are people who are smiling with you, but they are sorrowing in their heart. I speak to you by the Spirit of God. Do not sorrow, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. If you have to go through this journey, you need a smile, sir. Madam, you need a smile. Turn around to somebody and smile. And tell them you will go through this journey. You need, I said, joy is the supplier of the strength you need be for spiritual warfare. You need strength in the journey of life. And you need strength for spiritual warfare. In spiritual warfare, we do not become victorious because of how we look. It's not the size. It's not the beauty. What gives you victory in spiritual warfare
is
strength. So in Ephesians 6 and verse 10, before Paul begins to talk about warfare, he says, be strong in the Lord. Be strong, finally, my brethren. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Be strong in the Lord, because strength is necessary for victory in the battles of life, for spiritual warfare. To be joyless is to be weak spiritually. And when you are weak spiritually, you are at risk of losing spiritual battles. You can pray with all seriousness, but if joy is not there, you will still lose it, because your strength is not in how your face looks. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal. So that I made my face serious is not what will scare the devil. It's a lie. Satan is not scared by bold face. Otherwise, all the fearful people will be very victorious. I thought you would say amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Why do you need the joy of the Lord? Because the joy, number four, is the fruit of the Spirit. Galatians 5 and verse 22. The presence of joy is evidence of the presence of the work of the Holy Spirit in the life of a man. That means when joy is living, Holy Ghost is not working. It means you are not embracing the person of a Holy Ghost. It is possible to be in the midst of trouble, but if you allow Holy Ghost to be at work in you, the joy of the Lord will be there. Hallelujah. Because it is a fruit of the Spirit. Why the joy of the Lord? Number five, because joy is the antidote for depression. It is the medicine for depression. James 1 and verse 2. Count it pure joy My brethren, when you fall into various trials, what James is saying is, instead of getting depressed when you enter a challenge, allow the joy of the Lord to find expression in your life, because you need the joy of the Lord. Let me hear somebody shout hallelujah. Receive the joy of the Lord. I say, receive the joy of the Lord. Receive the joy of the Lord. The remaining part of this conference, you will leap like a calf. You will dance around here, because the hand of God is upon you, and God wants to bring restoration. I said, God wants to bring restoration. Hallelujah. You are saying, Pastor, things are tough. Everything is difficult. The Bible says there is a difference when it comes to how God treats the people that are born of Him. Malachi chapter 4 and verse number 2. Verse number 1 says the earth will burn like an oven. Amen. And everything will be tough and difficult. But in verse 2 he says, but to you, amen, but to you who fear my name, lift up your hand and say, I fear his name. The Bible says, but to you that fear my name, the Son of Righteousness, Jesus, Jesus, the Son of Righteousness, will arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go out and grow fat. You only grow fat because you are eating. So what Malachi is saying, while everybody out there is hurting and suffering and under pressure, Jesus will make sure you are eating. I thought I had you say amen. He said you will go out. You will grow fat like a stall fed cow. I love the NIV. The NIV talks about you running, leaping. Amen. It says that, and you will go out and leap, because you are healthy, because you are well fed. Thank you for coming to Mountain Takers Conference. The word you are receiving is putting you on the course of divine supply. It will bring you on the course of divine supply. God will provide for you. You will not go down when everything is going down. When they say there is a going down, you will arise and declare there is a lifting. So I declare a lifting to somebody here. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Another area God wants to restore. So we have talked about joy. Number two is wasted years. Very briefly, let me talk about wasted years. It's possible to waste years. It's possible to waste time. It's possible for a year to pass and you didn't achieve anything. It's possible for 5 years to pass and you didn't achieve anything. There are people who have wasted 10 years. There are people who have wasted 3 years. There are people who have wasted 7 years. And there are people here. For the last 1 year, nothing has been happening. You have registered no progress. I came to announce a restoration of wasted years. Joel 2:25. I will restore to you the years. That is God talking. God is saying, I will restore to you the years. You lost a year. Good news. There is restoration. How does God restore lost years? Number one, God restores lost years by increasing your strength. As you grow older, I pray for somebody here. As you grow older, become stronger. Deuteronomy 33 and verse 25. Deuteronomy 33:25. The Bible says, hallelujah. The Bible says, your sandals shall be iron and bronze as your days, so shall your strength be. I pray for somebody here. The more you advance, the stronger you will become. You didn't hear me, so let me move. Psalm 103 and verse 5. Hallelujah. Psalm 103, verse number 5. The Bible says, who satisfied your mouth with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. May you receive renewal of your youth on this mountain. May your youth be renewed. Anything that was dying in your life, I command life. Anything that was weakening in your body, I command strength. I thought I heard somebody shout hallelujah. How does God restore years? Number two, by giving you another chance. We serve the God of another chance. The last opportunity you blew was not the only opportunity you have. There is another chance for you. Before the end of this month, I prophesy another chance. Before the end of this week, another opportunity is coming your way. I don't care how many opportunities you have blown. God is a God of 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 100 chances. Another chance is coming your way. As you come out of this conference, God will give you another chance. Hallelujah. Naomi told Ruth, go to your people. Even if I gave birth to a son right now, he cannot grow to a point of marrying you. She is telling Ruth, you don't have a chance. But Ruth said, wherever you go, I will go. Your people, where you die. When she came to the land of bread, God gave her another chance. I said, God gave Ruth another chance. And that chance was not with a weakling. The husband was a weakling. Killion, Malon, one was weakling, one was dying. Receive another chance in the name of Jesus. Don't get discouraged. There is another chance for you. You lost a relationship, God has another one. You lost an opportunity, God has another one. If you are getting me, shout hallelujah. I prophesy another opportunity. And this time you will do it better. David was bringing the ark to Jerusalem. He didn't do it the right way. He didn't give up. He went to the men of God and asked them, what do we do? And they said, when you did the first time, you didn't do it right. David said, tell me how to do it right. And they explained to him. And he did it right. God is giving you another chance. This time you will do it right. I said this time you will have results. Last time you failed. This time you will not fail. Last time you were ashamed. This time you will not be ashamed. Last time you were dismayed, you looked so bad. This time you will come out shining. I say you will come out shining. Can I hear somebody shout hallelujah? May the Lord give you another chance. I say, may the Lord give you another chance. How does God restore wasted years? Number three, by giving you speed. Divine speed. The speed of heaven. 1 Kings chapter 18 and verse 46. And the hand of God came upon Elijah. I pray on this mountain, the hand of the Lord will come upon you. I say the hand of the Lord will come upon you. I always say years ago, I was left very far. My peers left me very far. My college mates left me very far. But I kept the presence of God. One day, the hand of God came upon my life. Today I realize that I have caught up. And I always tell people, there is something called a catch-up anointing. It's called catch-up. They left you very far. But then God puts his hand on you. And then he moves you. And you discover you are closer to them. And they look at you and wonder, how did you arrive here? The last time we saw you, you are very far. I tell them the hand of God, divine speed. I tell them I may not be as powerful a preacher, but there is a God of speed. I say there is a God of speed. I may not have chariots like the ones of Ahab, but there is a God. I'm telling somebody here, there is a God. Hallelujah. I pray for you. God will give you speed. I say God will give you speed. Every step you take after now will be a miracle. It will be a miracle. I said it will be a miracle. Shout hallelujah. There is something we call a jump of faith. A jump of faith. I told some people some years ago, God is going to give me 1, 2, 3. They said no. God has to take you slowly. Because they didn't understand. There is a God of taking steps. But there is a God of taking jumps. It's possible to take steps. But there is another dimension where it's not steps we are taking. It is jumps. I prophesy a jump of faith for somebody here. I said I prophesy a jump of faith for somebody here. Receive divine speed. I said receive divine speed. When Ahab looked back, Elijah was here. He looked again. Elijah is gone. On foot. Ahab is on chariots. Receive the catch-up anointing. I said, receive the catch up anointing. May God help you to catch up. I said, may God help you to catch up. May God help you to catch up. That's why on this mountain, don't worry about who went ahead. Concentrate on Jesus. Concentrate on the word of God. Recovery is a possibility. Restoration is a possibility. Can I hear you shout hallelujah? Praise the Lord. I say praise the Lord. Amen.
Amina.
And I said, tonight, we're going to find out whether the devil that you serve or the God that I serve has more power.
We believe in the healing gospel that must be preached through high-quality media production and the latest cinematic technology, reaching the unreached all over the world. The word taught, revealed, expanded, expounded, and embedded deep into the heart of mankind awakens the mind to focus rightfully. Yes, darkness cannot stand in the way of the light, and the light of the world is here. Walk in the light and live a good life. Watch Redeemer's Voice TV, available on Bumba TV, GoTV, Stir Times, and digital free-to-air decoders and TVs. Redeemer's Voice TV, bringing the liberating truth.